my channel. My name's Emma and today I'm going to share with you my experience in having a thyroid storm. So I love sharing my health journey here with you on YouTube. A little bit about me is that back in 2013, I was diagnosed with Graves' disease and hyperthyroidism. I then suffered from those diseases for 4.5 years, and then I ended up having a total thyroidectomy in 2017. So I'm not a doctor. Everything that I tell you is just from my personal experience and what my doctors have told me and my own research. So please, if you think you are having any symptoms or you know you need further medical advice, always seek a health professional so you can see your regular doctor or an endocrinologist who specializes in thyroid diseases. So when I was first diagnosed with hyperthyroidism and Graves' disease, it came on really, really fast. I wasn't sick, I was professionally dancing, and it really came as a shock. And the first experience that I had, I started having tremors, my eyes started protruding, and I kept getting misdiagnosed as having allergies, which wasn't the case. It wasn't until I was rushed to hospital and my heart rate was 100, if I can remember correctly, I believe it was 198 beats per minute, which I very, very easily could have had a heart attack. I think if I wasn't as fit as I was, I probably would have. So I was really lucky that I went straight to the emergency department and they gave me some medication, and luckily my heart rate came down. I was told to be on complete bed rest until I could see some doctors a couple of days later, because it actually was Christmas time in Australia, so everything was shut. So that was a bit of a tricky time to have that happen to me. But moving forward, so back to a thyroid storm. So during the time of having Graves' disease and hyperthyroidism, I did go into remission for 9 months. But unfortunately, I relapsed. So during that time, I wasn't on any medication, and unfortunately, I ended up relapsing. Not long after I relapsed, I moved overseas to Dubai. And it was when I was in Dubai that I went into a thyroid storm. So by definition, let me just tell you what a thyroid storm is. I'm reading from my phone. A thyroid storm is a life-threatening health condition that is associated with untreated or undertreated hyperthyroidism. During a thyroid storm, an individual's heart rate, blood pressure, and body temperature can soar to dangerously high levels. So the reason why I went into a thyroid storm was because I was no longer responding to my medication. So it wasn't that I wasn't treating my condition. I was seeing an endocrinologist here in Dubai monthly. I was getting blood tests, but it just got to the stage where my body it wouldn't accept the medicine anymore, and my entire body was just overworking. So I'm reading from my phone. What does a thyroid storm feel like? Here it says, so hyperthyroidism can cause sweating, feeling hot, palpitations, and weight loss. The symptoms of a thyroid storm are more severe. So they can result in complications such as fever, dehydration, and rapid heart rate. And that's what was happening to me. So it got to the stage where I couldn't walk anymore. I remember one day my husband and I were catching a bus, and I couldn't get down the bus. Like, I couldn't get down the stairs on the bus, and I had to call out to him, you know, help me, and he had to carry me off the bus. I could not walk up or downstairs. That was really impossible for me. After, you know, say if we go to the mall or something, I could only walk for, you know, maybe 30 minutes maximum, and then we'd have to sit down and I'd need a rest. So I really couldn't be active, and the doctors ended up telling me that I needed to be bedridden until I was strong enough to fly home to Australia and get surgery, because that's where I decided I wanted to get surgery, in Australia, not in Dubai. So the reason for that was just I wanted to be closer to my family because of my husband's job. He wasn't really able to take care of me, you know, 24/7 like I kind of needed after surgery. So we made the decision it would be best for me to fly home, be with my family, and have the treatment done in Australia. So other things that happened to me during the thyroid storm, I was still I was eating a lot, but I wasn't as, you know, starving as I was when I was first diagnosed. I remember I would have two or three dinners every night, and I ate all day long. Whereas during the thyroid storm, I was still eating a lot more than I normally do, but I didn't have that huge appetite. I was extremely underweight. I believe I was like 48 kilos. Normally I'm, you know, in the 50s, so I was pretty underweight there. What else happened? My tremors were just out of control. Like I couldn't pick anything up. I was continuously shaking. My thyroid at this stage became really enlarged. Now, if you look back at some of my older videos, you will see, I think there's one where I talk about my relapse. You can see my neck is really quite big. So I know that some people's thyroids get enlarged even more than mine did, but you know, for me at that stage, it was quite enlarged. I'm just trying to think and remember what else happened. So basically I was always sweaty. I just felt really uncomfortable. I was really like foggy in the brain. You know, my husband would always be like, "Are you okay?" And I'd be like, "Yeah, I'm okay." Like just really airy and just no concentration. I think I could really tell that something serious was going on, and my natural reaction when there is something wrong with me, like if I'm ill or, you know, I'm in a stressful situation, I naturally go into like this meditative state, and that's kind of what my body did the whole time. I just would lie there and just, you know, keep myself calm because I knew and I could feel that if I started to feel stressed or, you know, I exerted myself too much, then my symptoms would flare up. I also, at the time, I was reacting very severely to gluten, so I had to cut out all gluten from my diet. If I would eat it, my stomach would swell up and I would look like I was pregnant. It would just turn into this hard rock and the pain was excruciating. So I cut out gluten. I also cut out a lot of refined sugar, and that really seemed to help my symptoms. But basically, when I got home to Australia, I booked in to see, I'm so sorry if you can hear hammering right now. They're doing construction work in the apartment below me. I'm very sorry about that. So when I got home to Australia, I saw the surgeon straight away and he looked at me and he just said, "Look, like, you know, we really have to operate straight away. It's just not safe for you to go on like this any longer." I ended up getting the surgery a week later. That's how severe I was. If you want to see what my recovery was like, I have some videos about that, which I will link below, and also I'll link at the end of this video. Basically that's what happened during my thyroid storm. It was really scary. I could tell something serious was going on. Mainly the scariest thing was definitely your heart. So your heart races so fast, you can see it popping out of your chest. And I was exhausted. It was, you know, now being healthy and thinking back on how that was, if you're going through that, I'm so sorry, and I really hope that you can get better soon, because it is debilitating. Like, you can't do anything. I remember just lying in the bed, just sleeping and eating and just praying that I would get better, basically, and like living I did. I think that's everything. That's basically what happened during my thyroid storm. The main thing is that, you know, you can't walk, and that's such a strange thing, being someone who was quite, you know, quite fit, and then not being able to walk is a very scary thing. The weakness, all my muscle, like I had no muscle mass anymore. My body just, I don't know, just ate it all away. Another strange thing that happened, I like being a dancer, so I was pretty flexible, you know, like as you are when you're a dancer. I lost all my flexibility, and even now I'm still nowhere near as flexible as I was, which is to be expected because I'm not training anymore, but I still stretch. But my muscles, they just became so tight. I guess it was just, you know, the different acids and whatnot going through my body, different hormone changes and everything. But I remember, like, for me, easily I can touch my toes, easily I can do the splits. I couldn't do any of those things. My hamstrings were just like a rock. And that was a really interesting thing for me. If you've ever suffered from fibromyalgia, you would know that like your muscles, they just ache, your feet and your calf muscles, they burn. And I would have that every day. Even if I didn't do anything, they would just burn. My joints were really achy. it was really painful. Not only are you having all these emotional reactions and, you know, symptoms, you're also having all these physical ones, and it's really painful and exhausting. So that is my story of my thyroid storm. I hope you found this helpful. Like I said, if you know you think you're going through anything, please seek professional help from a doctor. I hope that, you know, my story has helped you. Don't give up hope. You will get better. I am living proof that you can get better from this. So if you have any questions, please leave them down below. You know, my DMs are always open on Instagram. I love chatting to you guys there. It's like, you know, a bit more private. If you have any, you know, personal questions you want to ask me, I'm more than happy to answer whatever I can for you. And I hope you have a wonderful day. I wish you so much health and happiness, and I'll see you in my next video.